Thank you. Good afternoon and evening, church. Do you know who we are? The body of Christ. What's our job description? Love God, love neighbor, make disciples. Welcome to our Ash Wednesday service in the midst of pandemic and weather, of all things. Maybe you have some ashes somewhere around. Doesn't have to be fancy. The church has traditionally used ashes from burning palm leaves from the prior Palm Sunday, but that's okay. By the way, I don't recommend doing that. It smells a little bit like a controlled substance when you do it. So at any rate, if you've got some ashes out of the fireplace, maybe out of the barbecue, don't go crazy. You don't need much. And then what I've done is simply get myself some of my olive oil that I have in the pantry. And again, you don't need much. It can be any sort of vegetable oil, baby oil, if you don't mind the smell. It can be water. Water will simply not stick as well and give way sooner. So, you know, put a little dab of oil in there, and mix the ashes until it's sort of pasty. And that's the paste we'll use during the service. Welcome to First United Methodist Church. The grace of the Lord Jesus Christ be with you. Bless the Lord who forgives all our sins. God's mercy endures forever. Sunday's palms are Wednesday's ashes. As another Lent begins, so we pray before our Maker in contrition for our sins. We have marred baptismal pledges, in rebellion gone astray. Now returning, seek forgiveness. Grant us pardon, God, this day. We are hasty to judge others, blind to proof of human need, and our lack of understanding demonstrates our inner greed. We have wasted Earth's resources, want and suffering we've ignored. Come and cleanse us, then restore us, make new hearts within us, Lord.
This is Matthew chapter 6, verses 1 through 6 and verses 16 through 21. Be careful not to practice your righteousness in front of others to be seen by them. Otherwise, you have no reward with your Father in heaven. So whenever you give to the poor, don't sound a trumpet before you do, as hypocrites do in the synagogues and on the streets, to be applauded by people. I truly tell you, they have their reward. But when you give to the poor, don't let your left hand know what your right hand is doing, so that your giving may be in secret. And your Father who sees in secret will reward you. Whenever you pray, you must not be like the hypocrites, because they love to pray standing in the synagogues and on the street corners to be seen by people. Truly, I tell you, they have their reward. But when you pray, go into your private room, shut your door, and pray to your Father who is in secret. And your Father who sees in secret will reward you. Whenever you fast, don't be gloomy like the hypocrites, for they make their faces unattractive so that their fasting is obvious to people. Truly, I tell you, they have their reward. But when you fast, put oil on your head and wash your face so that your fasting isn't obvious to others, but to your Father who is in secret. And your Father who sees in secret will reward you. Don't store up for yourselves treasures on earth, where moth and rust destroy and where thieves break in and steal. But store up for yourself treasures in heaven, where neither moth nor rust destroys, and where thieves don't break in and steal. For where your treasure is, there your heart will be also. This is the word of God for the people of God.
Will you join me as we pray? May the words of my mouth and the meditations of our hearts be acceptable in thy sight, O Lord, our strength and our Redeemer. Amen. If you manage to stick with all those Marvel movies, the Avengers and Iron Man and Thor and all those, if you manage to stick right through to the end of the saga, and heaven knows I lost count how many movies that was, the last one was really well put together and had one scene that I just thought was delightful. It was very tender. Iron Man, Tony Stark, had a daughter, and he went in one night to tell her goodnight. And they talked for a little while, and as he got up to leave, she said to him, "I love you 3,000. I love you 3,000. Isn't that neat? Sometimes we use numbers to try and express something that we don't really know how to put a quantity on. And it's true in the Bible, too. The Bible talks about that when the Hebrews were led out of Egypt by Moses, that they wandered in the wilderness for 40 years. And the prophet Elijah, at one point, had to run from Jezebel the queen. And when he did that, God sent him food, and that food lasted him for 40 days. And then there's the story of Jesus, who after his baptism was driven into the wilderness by the Spirit. And while he was in the wilderness, he fasted 40 days. Now, if you look at your calendar starting today, and you count the days, not Sundays, but count all the other days, it is 40 days until Easter. Now, we use the exact 40 because in the 21st century, we're all mathematicians. We understand about numbers. There are exact numbers and there are whole numbers and fractions and all kinds of things. But we understand about numbers. But back in the biblical days, numbers weren't quite as nailed down as they are now. And so instead of saying a whole lot of, they'd say, "Oh, we wandered in the wilderness 40 years. It would be like saying, "I love you 3,000. Ah, we wandered in the wilderness for 40 years. Elijah fasted for 40 days. Jesus was in the wilderness for 40 days. What it means is a whole lot of. We wandered in the wilderness a long time. Elijah had to go for a long time without food. Jesus was in the wilderness a long time." And if that's the biblical way of thinking about things, then friends, you and I have now been in the wilderness a long time, more than 40 days. We've been in this wilderness of pandemic and quarantine and COVID-19, 40 months. And it's an exaggeration. It's simply a way of expressing a whole lot of. But as a people, not only in the church, but as a people in the community, as a people in the nation, as a people of the world, we've been in the wilderness a whole lot of. We've been in the wilderness for 40 months, and sometimes it feels like 40 years. We've been in the wilderness like the Hebrews were, wandering around, forging a relationship with God. We've been in the wilderness like Jesus was, testing our baptismal vows, looking to fulfill our call. Now, I will confess to you, that all those people who fasted for 40 days, that has not been one of my pandemic rituals, one of my pandemic disciplines. COVID-19, as far as I'm concerned, does not refer to the year that this thing was diagnosed. It may refer to the number of pounds I've gained while we've been in pandemic. But we've been in the wilderness. And sometimes that wilderness has led us away from things. That wilderness has led us away from good eating habits. That wilderness has led us away maybe from our prayer habits. That wilderness has led us away from being in touch with the people we love because we're tired of the phone. We're tired of Zoom. We're tired of the internet. And it feels like we've been wandering in the wilderness for 40 years. Ash Wednesday begins a 40-day observance. And this year it may feel like all 40 days. But Ash Wednesday has always been within the church just the start of something. We may start in the wilderness, but we're not going to end up in the wilderness. We may start in the wilderness and we may go to the cross, but we're not going to end up in either the wilderness or the cross. We may start in the wilderness and end up at the cross and stand at the tomb. But God does not leave us in the wilderness. God does not leave us at the cross. God does not leave us at the tomb. Ash Wednesday is simply a signal. Here's the beginning. And in that journey, the Good Shepherd is coming into that very wilderness to pull us out, to pull us past the ashes, to pull us past our sin, to get us past the cross, to push us beyond the tomb. All 40 days of it. The end of the pandemic is in sight. And let's face it, life is not going to go back to normal. There's going to be a new normal. And Ash Wednesday starts us on 40 days. 40 days to the cross, to the tomb. But God will not leave us there. The end is in sight. And resurrection is our new normal. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen.
Hello, friends. I am grateful to join you on this Ash Wednesday from my home because it's still so nasty outside. I invite you now to join me as I invite you into a holy Lent. Dear brothers and sisters in Christ, the early Christians observed with great devotion the days of our Lord's Passion and Resurrection, and it became the custom of the church before the Easter celebration that there should be a 40-day season of spiritual preparation. During this season, converts to the faith were prepared for holy baptism, and it was also a time when persons who had committed serious sins and had separated themselves from the community of faith were reconciled by penitence and forgiveness, and restored to participation in the life of the church. In this way, the whole congregation was reminded of the mercy and forgiveness proclaimed in the gospel of Jesus Christ, and the need we all have to renew our faith. I invite you, therefore, in the name of the church, to observe a holy Lent by self-examination and repentance, by prayer, fasting, and self-denial, by reading and meditating on God's holy word, to make a right beginning of repentance, and as a mark of our moral nature, let us now bow before our Creator and Redeemer. Let us take a moment of silence, friends. Friends, I now will give thanks over the ashes. Please bow your heads with me as I pray. Almighty God, you have created us out of the dust of the earth. Grant that these ashes may be to us a sign of our mortality and our penitence, so that we may remember that only by your gracious gift are we given everlasting life. Through Jesus Christ, our Savior. Amen.
Repent and believe the gospel.
And now I will read from Psalm 51. I invite you, if you have a hymnal at home, to turn along with me, because we are on page 785. I will read the main print and you will be the bold print. If you're joining us at home, these words will be on the bottom of your screen. Have mercy on me, O God, according to your steadfast love. According to your abundant mercy, blot out my transgressions. Wash me thoroughly from my iniquity and cleanse me from my sin. For I know my transgressions and my sin is ever before me. Against you and you only have I sinned and done what is evil in your sight, so that you are justified in your sentence and blameless in your judgment. Behold, I was born into iniquity, and I have been sinful since my mother conceived me. Behold, you desire truth in my inward being, therefore teach me wisdom in my secret heart. Purge me with hyssop, and I shall be clean. Wash me, and I shall be brighter than snow. Make me hear with joy and gladness, let the bones which you have broken rejoice. Hide your face from my sins, and blot out all of my iniquities. Create in me a clean heart, O God, and put a new and right spirit within me. Cast me not away from your presence, and take not your Holy Spirit from me. Restore to me the joy of your salvation, and sustain in me a willing spirit. Then I will teach transgressors your ways, and sinners will return to you. Deliver me from death, O God, God of my salvation, and my tongue will sing aloud of your deliverance. O Lord, open my lips, and my mouth shall show forth your praise. For you have no delight in sacrifice. Were I to give a burnt offering, you would not be pleased. The sacrifice acceptable to God is a broken spirit. A broken and contrite heart, O God, you will not despise. Amen.
Just as I am without one plea, but that thy blood was shed for me, and that thou bidst me come to thee, O Lamb of God, I come. Just as I am, thy love unknown hath broken every barrier down. Now to be thine, yea, thine alone, O Lamb of God, I come. The grace of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ, the love of God, the communion and fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with us all, with those we love and those we find difficult to love, both now and always. Amen. Jesus, remember me when you come into your kingdom. Jesus, remember me when you come into your kingdom. Jesus, remember me when you come into your kingdom. Jesus, remember me when you come into your kingdom.